Hello and welcome to Formula One, Round 15 Brazil, Season 2. I started the episode without recording the first part, so I do apologise. But I think this was from the communications from the commentators. But we are listening tonight on the formation lap, so sit back, relax, enjoy the video and enjoy the music when it kicks in.
Formula One returns to Sao Paulo once again with the stage set for what promises to be another classic Brazilian Grand Prix. Sebastian Vettel famously clinched his third championship here in 2012. And in 2016, Max Verstappen treated us to one of the finest wet weather drives of all time. Interlagos, always a very special race here in Brazil. It's a 2.7-mile circuit with 9 lefts and 6 rights for a total of 15 corners. But it's a wet one today, so grip and visibility will be at a premium, and the drivers will need to be careful coming up the hill in Sector 3, the scene of many an accident over the years. It's not going to be plain sailing for our drivers today, although with the sky falling as it is, perhaps sailing isn't too far from the truth. Anthony Davidson, could be a wet one today. Great to have you with us. What are your thoughts?
It is a touch damp, isn't it? Well, as a driver, there are three big things to worry about when racing in these kind of conditions. Standing water, tyre temperature and visibility. Judging distance to the cars around you is really tricky when you're driving through the vast amounts of spray that these wet weather Pirelli tyres kick up.
Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position and Lando Norris lines up alongside. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Perez, Verstappen, Daniel Ricciardo, and Rosberg, Lee Bottas, Fernando Alonso, and George Russell. Leclerc, they'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty. Stroll, Antonio Giovinazzi, and Gasly, Vettel, Mazepin, Nicholas Latifi. They've taken a grid penalty. And Yuki Tsunoda, Mick Schumacher, Joe, Alesi. They'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty. And Esteban Ocon rounds off the grid. That's it then, it's time to go racing as we head to trackside for today's race.
Okay, go through all the gears if you can. We need to make sure the engagement is okay before the start. We're going to want to put some temperature into the tyres and brakes. We need to keep the engine cool though, so don't go too high with the revs. Rain's easing off a bit, but the track is still going to be wet for a while.
Yeah.
The rest of the grid is forming up. Be patient and watch for the lights. A worrying level of wear on the internal combustion engine. Let's try and keep the revs down. Early upshifts, later downshifts. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Okay, good work. Great pass. That was the fastest lap of the race. Keep this up. The car behind is dropping back. We're seeing a gap form. Good job. That was the fastest lap of the race so far. Okay, the weather's certainly eased off for the time being, but we've still got a lot of standing water out there. We're happy for you to stay out on the inters for now.
Right, some information on Hamilton. They're slowing down. It seems like there's some kind of problem with their car. Left of this rain, then we think it's going to dry up. 10 minutes. Tire condition for now, everything's looking good. We don't currently have the data for that request. Roger that. Soft tyres at the next pit stop. We're leading our teammate by 14.3 seconds. Gap to teammate behind is 14.5 seconds. They're on fresh inters. They're in seventh. The time last lap was a 1:24.6. Are you okay? That was a big one. Confirm you're okay, please. been an incident on track resulting in loose debris. Fortunately, the marshals have managed to clear it up in time and there are no plans for a safety car right now. We're looking at another 5, maybe 10 minutes of this rain. Inters seem like the fastest tyre for now. That was the fastest lap of the race. Keep this up. We're accumulating some wear on the MGUK. To manage this, we'll need to lower our ERS deployment mode. We're leading our teammate by 27.3 seconds. A new strategy is available. There's been an incident on track, but officials aren't looking to push for a safety car right now. Just be careful. We've been awarded a time penalty. It will go against our finishing time at the end of the race. The situation is an interesting one, but I think the right call is to stick with what we've got right now.
Box this lap.
Right, come in at the end of this lap. Release. Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound. Copy. The gap to the car ahead is 1.6 seconds.
Weather report.
Conditions look stable at the moment. No rain currently expected. Inters look like the best tyre for now. We're increasing our gap on the car behind by around a second a lap. Charger is on its last legs. Let's try to keep mileage on it to a minimum. DRS has been enabled. DRS is now enabled. There's 5 laps of fuel remaining. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. A new strategy is available on the MFD. Copy that. Good job. That was the fastest lap of the race so far. There's been an incident on track, but officials aren't looking to push for a safety car right now. Just be careful. There's 4 laps of fuel remaining. Work. That's a new fastest lap of the race.
Fantastic drive, just fantastic. You deserve that race win.
That's a spectacular victory then, and with it, the championship is secure. It's been a magnificent season, and they thoroughly deserve the cheers of the crowd here today. Tell me, Ant, how do you think they were able to deliver such an incredible result today?
I think the key here is just the quality of the racecraft, you know? I mean, how many overtakes did they make overall? I'm sure we have a stat person keeping score somewhere. It's fantastic to watch, isn't it? This is a strategic sport at the end of the day, but it's always really gratifying to see close-fought battles on track. It's what all the fans are after.
Well, I'm thoroughly exhausted after the excitement of that race, but I'm sure it's nothing compared to our drivers here. They've worked hard to make it up there, and it's great to see them make their way out onto the podium. Let's discuss, Ant. Who would you say is a contender for driver of the day?
I have to give it to Lee. They fought so hard and had incredible pace at times, so I don't think anyone else did a better job today.
With that result, the sport's newest team can no longer be touched at the top of the table. What an incredible journey this has been for a team many had written off a short time ago. They are Formula One world champions. Meanwhile, good work from Aston Martin this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order.
The fans really seem to enjoy that. You made it look easy. How are you feeling after that? You really look... How do you think... Did you feel comfortable? Great. Well, that's everything.
Thank you.
Right, so yeah, I'm going to say thank you very much for watching. Please like, subscribe, share, hit the bell for notifications. And the Australian Grand Prix will be tomorrow. And until then, I will see you all again. Goodbye.